Hello everyone, I'm Abhishek Bainwar, trainee software consultant at Nautilus Incorporated. So topic of the today's session is why Catalan Studio. Before diving into the Catalan Studio, let me ask you some few questions. So how many of you work with APIs? Great. And how many of you work with web applications? And anyone got chance works with a mobile application, no matter iOS, Android or hybrid apps? It's okay. Okay, then you guys are my target audience. Let's start. So before starting the topic, let's discuss knowledge etiquette. So first, respect knowledge session timings. You are requested to not to join after the 5 minutes post the session. Make sure to submit the constructive feedback for all the session, because feedbacks are very important for the every presenter. So third is keep your mobile devices on silent. Feel free to move out if in case of any urgency. And the last, avoid any unwanted chit chat during the session. So agenda for the today's session would be introduction, where we learn about what is Catalan Studio, who don't know about the Catalan Studio, where should we use it, and how, and the minimum features, etc. And next is key features. And we will discuss about the key feature of the Catalan Studio. And third is why Catalan Studio. The focus topic of the today's focus topic is. So why should we use Catalan Studio? How it's different from other application exists in market, and etc. And third, other products provided by Catalan Studio. And fourth, integration involved with the Catalan Studio provided by the Catalan Studio. And strengths of the Catalan Studio, and last but not the least, limitations of the Catalan Studio. So let's start. So introduction. What is Catalan Studio? Basically, Catalan Studio is a free automation testing solution developed by the Catalan LLC. The software is built on the top of the Selenium Selenium framework, Appian, with the specialized IDE interface. And its first public release was in September 2016. So this application is free of course. You don't have to pay anything. It's robust, strong, and cross-platform. Now you can use this application in Ubuntu, Linux distribution, any Linux distribution, Windows, and Mac as well. And it's automated. Talking about automation, what you guys have idea about the automation? What you guys think about the automation?
Testing some feature automatically, and getting some scripts which test our APIs or test our business functionality.
Right. Basically, Funda is to don't repeat same task again and again. You can use that time in other things like other tasks, other works, and you can watch Game of Thrones as well. So supporting testing types are API testing, mobile testing, no matter iOS, Android, and hybrid apps as well. And also supports web application testing as well. So moving on, these are the key features of the Catalan Studio. Hassle-free deployment, quick and easy setup, better and faster result, flexible modes, easy to use, and multi-OS application. So let's discuss discuss them one by one. So hassle-free deployment, basically it's, Catalan Studio is completely deployable package. Basically, this package contains everything you want to deploy on any AWS console server or anywhere on the web. So quick and easy setup. Installing Catalan Studio is very easy, and its environment installation is very easy. You just have to download it, register it through your mail ID and password, and activate it through mail ID and password, and you are ready to go. So better and faster result. Catalan Studio has basically templates and a tutorial which will help any tester or developer to work with it in no time. So flexible modes. Now you guys are thinking this is a testing application and only tester want it. No. It also provides the scripting mode, so the developers also can work with it. And easy to use. You guys are thinking this is a complete IDE, Catalan Studio, like other applications which could be very tough to use, but no. Even a person with minimal programming language can work with it. multi-OS application. As I said, this application can run on Ubuntu, my Windows, and Linux as well, and Mac as well. So today's main agenda, why Catalan Studio? There are other products as well, like Selenium, TestNG, etc, etc. So Catalan Studio hides all the complexity behind the scenes and provide friendly UI. Just you can use Catalan Studio without any problem. But still, if you want to dig into more important things, like most of the programmers, developers want to use Catalan Studio, but they think this is so easy and they don't think they can do more work on it. So scripting mode is for them, developers, yes. So with Selenium, users have to go through technical guidelines to set up with IDE for the test cases. While Catalan Studio provides the bundle of which includes almost all necessary things like Java, Android SDK, web drivers to drive the browsers. So while Selenium and APM requires users to build common and reusable actions on their own, Catalan Studio contains the certain set of keywords. They can be used again and again for those actions. Still, if you want to use some of the functionalities again and again, if your project has some requirement for that, then Catalan Studio also provides that too. You can create custom keywords so that you can use those actions again and again. So this is the image where I have compared all the testing tools like Catalan, Selenium, HPUFT for other on the basis of these criteria like available syncs, license, pricing, supported platform, and etc. etc. As you can see, Catalan Studio is coming top of them. So it's available from 2015, it's free, supported more than four platforms, easy to use, easy installation, and normal, easy to navigate, and its community is small. So we have learned about what is Catalan Studio, why should we use it, and how it's different from the other applications, right? Let's discuss some others. Catalan Studio is not just a testing tool, right? It also provides two more features like Catalan Analytics and Catalan Recorder, where Catalan Studio gives you two functionality to test the APIs, web application, and mobile. There, Catalan Analytics use those test results, reports, and provide you the representation in the form of graphs, pie charts, and as well. And other part of this is Catalan Recorder. You can it is a simple IDE where you can record all your test cases. You can play it, debug it, and export to different languages like Groovy, Ruby, Java, Python, etc. So we have talked about the Catalan products they offer by the services, and now we are talking about the integration. This is the best part. Catalan provides lots of integration. As you can see, if you want CI/CD implementation with this tool, then it provides Jenkins and Dockers and others. If you want to run test cases through Jira, most of the projects have test cases written on the Jira as well. If you want to run them through Jira, you just have to clone them from Jira and they are going to run. And also, if you want to keep track of those test cases, like if they have written new test cases, they have added a new test case, if they have deleted a new test case, or anything else, simple integration of Slack will notify everything about that. And everything we talked just about, we are missing with a version control system. Basically, Catalan provides that too. You can just clone the source code from the repository, and you can run by using just play button. That's the best part. And other testing frameworks, they provided integration with the Catalan Studio. These are Qtest, Cobitron, SauceLabs, BrowserStack. These are the tools integration you can use to test on the different browsers, different devices, and all. So we have talked about the integration, right? Let's discuss its strengths. So first is no licensing or maintenance fee. Basically, you don't have to pay anything for the maintenance and the license, right? Second is IDE with Tabular and scripting mode. Here, it's saying the QA and the developer both can work on the Catalan Studio. Scripting mode for developers and the Tabular mode for QAs. Third is emerged at the top of the Selenium product. Selenium has launched lots of products, but still Catalan has just launched in 2016, but still it's coming out of them, on the top of them, basically. And last, no programming language skill needed. In technical domain, there are lots of technical people like data scientists, QA testers, programmers. All don't need to perfect in this programming language, right? They are all not perfect in the programming. So Catalan Studio is for them too. So we have talked about what is Catalan Studio, where should we use it, and the integration part and the strengths part. And I don't think any application is perfect, right? Even the nicest applications have their limits. So we are discussing the limitations part. So since it is launched in 2016, September 2016, it has a quickly growing community. And scripting mode for the developers, which I have talked about, is only available in Java and Groovy. And third, until it cannot be automate desktop applications. It can work with APIs, it can work with web application, it can work with mobile application, but not with desktop application. Still, they are working on it. They are going to launch about the Python, for Python and Rust as well. So we have talked enough. Let's see Catalan into the action. So as you can see, this is the Catalan UI. I have just installed it from the Catalan official website, registered with my email ID and activated through the same email ID and password. As you can see, there is a help tab. A single person who is not doesn't know how to run Catalan, all the functionality, recorder and the executor, all this given in the help portion. Since I have created a demo request for the API, as you can see, it's a dummy test case where I have selected the GET request, as you select in other testing framework as well. And I also have entered the dummy URL I got from over somewhere. So when I enter it, yes, as you can see the response of this URL. I have also created a post request as well. I have created a post, selected the post request and the URL I want and the body you want to post. When I enter, see, as status code 201 created, you can see the data and match it to body. So I have created another project so that you can see the collection of test cases. It's actually basically a test suite.
How is this different from Selenium?
Basically, Selenium has in Selenium you have to follow the all the methodologies to integrate your test cases with IDE, where you don't need to do with Catalan Studio. As you can see, there are lots of test cases, combination of test cases.
So for, like as you said, this also helps us for mobile application testing.
Yep.
In which way this helps us for mobile application testing?
Basically, UI, and if a mobile application is requesting any request from outer service, external service, then in that way.
So, there is like for a testing web application, we are creating a script which automatically opens the browser and fills the field.
Yes,
so
yes.
We can do same thing with this.
Yes, you can do it.
This run mobile application APK file.
No.
Like for Android or.
Basically, it downloads the package of that application. You don't need to load the APK file. Basically, it tests the UI of your Android app or web application.
For
yeah,
iOS application?
Yes, at same.
Download the package. I'm not getting the package.
Basically, if you can see, this is the option for Git. It checks out the code from the repository. And basically test the functionality directly. You don't need to load the APK file or something.
Okay. For that, okay.
Yeah.
There is actually download the whole source code of your mobile application.
Yes.
Then test it and do it.
Yes.
So it does not test the like final artifact. Does not test the
no.
APK.
No.
It tests the source code that will be converted to.
Yes.
APK.
So does it provide me an option to load test? I want to like get 1,000 requests
simultaneously
on a single endpoint. So can I do that?
Yes, you can do that. Here I have created the test cases, test collection basically. Let me show. There are 19 test cases. I have created collection of 19 test cases. I'm going to run them. As you can see, test cases are running.
This is a test suite you are running, right?
Right.
What she is asking is, can I run concurrently, right? Can I use it for load testing?
When reading one request?
No, you can't.
Sanity.
No.
This is not a load testing.
No.
It is for functional testing.
As you can see, the test cases are running in the log viewer. I think there's some net issue. Yes, test cases are running.
So here you are testing HTTP endpoints. Does this also support gRPC?
No. Until the test cases are running, you can see the Git and Jira integration here. You can load the test cases from the Jira, import test cases from the Jira, and here you can clone the whole project from the Git repository you want.
It is fine, but can I import Selenium test cases into this?
Yes.
The cases, the Selenium test cases which already exist.
Yep.
Can I run it through Catalan Studio or do I have to create them again?
Yes, actually Catalan is created through Selenium based in framework. So you can. I have added the positive and negative test cases both. So some test cases are failing and some test cases are passing.
And does it give PDF reports as well?
No, but that's where Catalan Analytics comes in handy. Basically, you can export these reports to Catalan Studio, and it will show you the graphical format of those reports, and you can track the whole software.
So this is a free software, right?
Yes.
Suppose I want to integrate this with my build. My Jenkins build.
Okay.
Basically, what happens is whatever test cases you have written here, okay, they should run automatically whenever the build has been deployed successfully on the environment.
Yep.
So how will we do that?
Can you come again? Actually.
So this is where, right? So where you will say, yeah, I have written the test cases, right? And now you provide the environment, and I will run those test cases. But if I want to basically automate this. In a continuous integration pipeline, right? then what we have to do is we have to basically run it as soon as the build is completed and deployed. I want to run these test cases.
Right.
Okay, so how can I do that?
Basically, as I said, you can just check in your code to Git repository, and Catalon will check out those test cases, and it will run those test cases on that platform you are using.
But then, is it like, if, for example, in Jenkins, is something like as soon as you have pushed, and it will pull it and automatically run the build and all that. So, this could be, can this be like automatically run?
No, I haven't explored it. Right.
Maybe because it has a Jenkins integration, right?
Mm.
So does it allow you to, does it have a Jenkins plugin which we can utilize to run it after the build? So that, I think that is a possibility, that because otherwise it is a hell lot of manual job.
Yes,
so
yes.
And we will not be able to do continuous integration because there will be manual intervention. So this tool will become popular only if they will have certain plugins where we can just say that write your test cases in Catalon and run it through your build.
Yes.
Maybe this is the reason why we have developer mode as well. We have developer
mode
as well.
Skip mode.
So by using that,
development mode will be just for writing the test cases, right? So basically, some people prefer scripting, right? So that they can write it quickly.
Okay.
So you can see there are 19 test cases are run, 14 of 19 are passed and 5 of them are failed. So that was our Catalon Studio.
So which are the companies that are using Catalon Studio for their testing? Any big names there?
Capgemini. Yep.
And who has basically built this tool?
Kotlin LLC. Catalon LLC. Okay, we have pretty much information about the Catalon Studio. What is Catalon Studio, where should we run it, what it does, what are the integrations. So I have concluded on this. This is a simple application, covers API, mobile and web testing, all three. And it's for both QA and the developers. And the most attraction of this application is the integration. CI/CD part includes Jenkins and Docker, Git, Jira, Slack, Qtest, etc. Ease of use. Basically, it is very easy to use. You just have to download it and go with it. Works on multiple operating systems, Windows, Mac, and Linux.
So, for example, in like Scala, I have like Scala test cases. Is it possible to do it through this or?
If your test cases are running on through any endpoint, then you can, like APIs, you are running any Scala application which is running through on APIs, microservices, or
everything. These are not unit test cases.
Yep.
So this is basically your functional test cases. So you are doing API testing. There you are basically doing method testing. The Scala test cases that you have written is basically for unit testing. This is not for unit testing tool. This is for functional testing.
But when you said that it can do mobile testing as well, so then there's no API involved. It's directly checking out code from the repository and running test cases. Is it hitting an endpoint in that?
So basically, in your mobile testing, so what exactly is your web testing? Like, how does Selenium work? So basically, for example, once you say that, click this button, right, and then it should take you to my profile page. Okay, so that is a functionality of your app. Okay, so now even so, basically in your Selenium, right, you will say there is an on-click event. Okay, and on-click, basically the page title should be user profile page. Okay, so this is that kind of testing it is talking about.
Okay, so these are the references. If you want to contact me for any sort of things about the Catalon Studio, and next time when you are going to test your APIs or web application or your mobile apps, like no matter Android, iOS or hybrid apps, don't forget to use Catalon Studio. Thank you.